happened.
The Electoral Commission officials appeared before the Legal Committee of Parliament today, seeking 177.2 billion shillings to kick off activities for the 2026 general elections.
The extent of the budget for the general elections, which is rather high, it is important that that budget be split in a phased manner, in a three-year phased manner.
According to the Electoral Commission, the first phase of the 2026 roadmap starts in the 2023-2024 financial year with a series of activities lined up. However, only 18.7 billion shillings has been allocated in the budget out of the 195 billion shillings required, leaving the Commission grappling with a funding gap of 177.2 billion shillings.
We have come to the committee to request and to appeal that funding gap be availed, because we cannot afford to postpone the activities that we should be conducting in the first phase.
The Commission plans to roll out different activities, including demarcation of parliamentary constituencies and local governments, reorganization of polling stations, among other activities.
And these require 195.958 billion. However, we only have 18.740 billion.
Legal committee members recognize the need to fund the Electoral Commission on time to avoid last-minute stampedes which compromise the quality of elections.
The idea of pumping Electoral Commission with lots of money in the last year compromises the process.
So those three financial years are interlinked. In fact, they are packed with activity. So there is need for government to release money to Electoral Commission so that Electoral Commission is able to conduct free and fair elections.
Similarly, the Electoral Commission has been forced to postpone LC1 and LC2 elections to the next financial year after failure by government to allocate funds for elections this financial year. Electoral Commission officials are concerned that while the current term of office for LC1 and LC2 expires in July this year, they are unable to conduct elections for their successors.
And the Commission had planned to conduct these elections during this financial year, but it seems it may not be possible. And this was to make sure that as their term lapses, the new office bearers are in place.
The Electoral Commission needs 60.8 billion shillings to conduct LC1 and LC2 elections, plus 54.8 billion shillings for Human Council Committee's elections, but not a single coin has been allocated in the 2023-2024 budget. Legislators, led by the committee chairperson, Robina Gureme Rakojo, are concerned that failure to conduct these elections have legal implications and also affect implementations of the parish development model, since LC1 leaders sit on the PDM committees.
My worry is that the women councils and the LC1s, they are members of the PDM committees, and we don't want to fail the PDM committees.
You find this one, 1 billion paid, other 19 are there pending, then you come up with something new.
Meanwhile, the legal committee has queried the Electoral Commission over 16 billion shillings which they spent to relocate to their temporary home in industrial area. Committee members contend that there was inflation.
The total budget for modifications, relocation, modifications, 16 billion.
You find the structure dilapidated, probably even isolated. And then you ask me to renovate at my own cost.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.